ClickUp, Monday.com, Basecamp, and Asana, all popular names in the project management space. Well, they're not going to be mentioned in today's video. Today, we're diving into 10 more project management applications as we look to help you find the best PM tool for you and your team. Hello there, I'm Francesco D'Alessio. I am one of the co-founders at Toolfinder, and we're going to help you find the best tools. All of the tools that we will mention today will be linked below in the description. And if you're interested in hunting for even more than the 10 we've got listed and the 10 that we put in a previous video, which you can find up here, then you can check out Toolfinder to hunt for all the project management apps. So let's begin. You've obviously been enlisted the task of researching project management apps, and that is a difficult task because you're trying to solve a lot of people's problems in your team. So what we're going to do is we're going to outline them, give them a pricing and information, as well as who they're best for, just so that you can dig a little bit deeper. Obviously, if you just want to explore the tool, check the description links out. But if you want to learn a little bit more about them individually, let's dive in. So the first one on our list is Monday.com Dev. Now, you're probably angry at me because at the start I did say I'm not going to include Monday.com. But this is a slightly different application because it looks like Monday, but it's built entirely for development teams. And this allows them to manage everything from issue tracking to sprints and bug tracking as well. Many people like the Monday.com feel, but they don't like apps like Jira, which are popular for issue tracking, and want something much more project management focused, that sort of blend between the two. Well, Monday.com Dev is a fully built system for those development teams and includes things like stakeholders and also product teams to jump in and be able to manage systems as well. So the pricing starts at $10 per user, and it looks like they have no free plan. This gives you some of the basic abilities, but there is additional upgrades to Standard and Pro to consider in this lineup. Now, who is Monday.com Dev best for? Development teams who are looking for something more flexible for project management every single day. Next up is an app called Quire, or Query. I don't know how it's actually pronounced, but it is a task management feel project management application for small and medium-sized teams. The idea behind it is creating a hierarchical structure where you can nest some of your tasks underneath other tasks and build out this system for you and your team. It has all of the traditional stuff you'd expect in project management tools, like the range of views and a way to be able to share and comment for team collaboration. But it has a range of abilities that people tend to like if they're looking for much more simplistic structures in their project management app. So in the free plan, you can get up to 10 members totally free. And you also get the Kanban board within there thrown into the free plan. Now, if you're going over those 10 members, you'll get it for $7.65 per user per month. And that unlocks a few more abilities like table view and a few more views. There are a premium, which gives you much more abilities when it comes to you and your team planning activities. So who is this one best for? It's probably for teams that are small to medium size, like task management as a focus for their project management, and want flexible ways to manage that. So that's how I would recommend Quire. Number three is Hive. Now, this isn't the British gas heating system, UK joke if you're watching. This is a project management application, and it's very much designed around team communication. Hive want you to ditch Slack and apps like that. It wants you to have chats and communication through the application and allows you to manage your projects alongside. Now, the application does have some all-round project management abilities, but it doesn't have as extensive abilities as you see in apps like Asana, but pretty decent for those who are maybe medium-sized business for looking for managing your projects as a team. The pricing is much more approachable with up to 10 users totally free, and you do get unlimited tasks, notes as well, with a 200 megabyte storage. The starter plan is fairly reasonable as well at $5 per user per month, which gets you access to a lot more. Who would I recommend Hive for? Unless you've got a boiler replacement, it's probably those who are small to medium sized teams who are looking for something more all round and versatile, focused on chat communication. Next one is called AppFlowy. Now, it's an open source document / project management application that has been growing in recent years. The application can be downloaded and allows teams to collaborate around documents and management of projects as well, using databases to coordinate what those look like. It sort of reminds me a lot like Notion, but very much focused on open source and teams collaborating in one location. The application has a free plan that includes unlimited pages and blocks, but limited to 2 members per workspace. So great if you would want to try this out and see if it's right for your small team. But then it goes at $10 per user per month and supports up to 10 workspace members. So probably not better if you're using it past 10 people. They do have AI add-ons, which allows you to do generative AI at $8 per user per month for the AI capabilities. So who's this one best for? Very small teams below 10 that want an open source alternative to Notion and want to be able to use it to manage their internal wiki and projects in one location. Next one is called Project.co. What a name for a project management application. Very solid choice. This application is designed mainly for client-facing companies that want to be able to share client portals with their people that they work with. And this is really nice. It looks like Basecamp, but has a slightly more different feel to it. In my opinion, maybe even slightly nicer. It allows you to collaborate with your clients and does have some generous offers in the free plan. The free plan does support up to 3 members and gives you 10 clients as well as 3 GB of storage. I can imagine the storage getting eaten up quite fast. But the pro plan offers $10 per user per month, offering unlimited members, clients, and storage, which I think is a fairly comprehensive pricing. Now, this one is great if you've got client-facing team that want to be able to share portals with their clients and see a really interactive environment for that. It's also got some artificial intelligence features that'll help you to build your workspaces much faster for client-facing work that you do. Next up is Scoro. Now, this one is more of a project management / resource management system that's going to cost you a fair amount of money because it tries to solve a bunch of different solutions. This application comes with planning, forecasting, and execution of all aspects of business operations, like client billing all the way to project management. Now, I mentioned the price is crazy. Let's hear it out. The essential plan covers $26 per user per month, but includes contact management, quoting, project management tools, time tracking, resource management, and invoicing. If you want more abilities, then Unlimited gives you everything, and it's priced at $63 per user per month. Now, this one is much more suitable for enterprises or large teams that want a whole business management system. It's going to replace a lot of different things that you already use, so it might be worth looking much deeper into this application and exploring it much further. More details can be found below, of course. Next up is Zoho Projects, and this one is actually touted as a much more cost-effective and well-rounded solution. So this application is part of what's called the Zoho ecosystem, and project management is part of that, allowing you to coordinate anything from timelines all the way to roadmaps and all the traditional project management abilities you see. If you're looking for something developer focused, they do have something called Zoho Sprints, which is an entirely different product. In terms of the generous pricing, it does have a free plan that includes up to 3 users, 2 projects, subtasks, and 5 GB storage. The premium is also really reasonable. For €4 per user per month, sorry, I couldn't find a US calculation for that and I didn't want to state something and then it'd be higher or lower. It includes unlimited projects, templates, time tracking, and blueprints. Blueprints is a really interesting feature that does automations for you with tasks, helping you to set up one and let it go in the background. So who's this best suited for? To be honest, it's budget-focused, small to medium-sized teams that want something reliable and easy to use. Zoho are a really credible developer in the space, and it's well worth considering it if you're in that remit. Next one is called Teamhood. It's like Robinhood for the project management space.
Oh, geez.
So Teamhood's designed mainly for agencies and service providers. It is very specific to those needs. It does also help with IT, but it allows you to manage your projects in those specific capacities. So it really works well with those guys because it does Gantt chart and also it does schedule management, which allows you to coordinate how much your team is working on and how to relieve the workload from other people. This obviously very popular in agencies and why they specialize in that area. Now, in terms of its pricing, the free plan supports up to 10 users, including the Kanban and the Gantt boards, which is really good, but does have a 100 megabyte file storage limit. The premium unlocked at $9.50 per user per month, unlocking additional features and increasing that storage. As I said, this one is great for agencies and service providers that want something robust and easy to use, yet flexible for their team. So I sort of bashed on this next one earlier a little bit. It's called Jira, and it's a very popular tool developed by a company called Atlassian, which is well known in the space for developing Confluence and Trello. It is a place for managing issue tracking for development teams. Now, many people like Jira because it's simple, easy to use, and has all the functionality, but others find it to be very stale in terms of how it's set up. But the application nonetheless helps you to coordinate and manage your workload and has some really generous free plans. So the free plan for Jira is up to 10 users, totally free, with unlimited projects, tasks, forms, but has some view limitation. The standard pricing starts at $8.15 per user, but if you're a larger team, it'll get cheaper and cheaper. The premium starts at $16 per user per month and comes with some AI-powered features. So if you're an agile team or you are a development team that uses agile, probably the same thing, then you are someone that will look at Jira because it's a robust and easy way to manage projects and issue tracking in one place. And finally, for a really sleek and attractive solution, it's Linear. Now, Linear's talked a lot about in the development team space as this newcomer in the space that wants to kill Jira. And because of that, it's very attractive and very easy to use. Now, Linear is designed for high performance teams in product and software development, and its free plan gives you unlimited users, but limits you to 250 issues tracked and two teams. The basic plan at $8 per user per month includes five teams, unlimited issues, and file upload. There's also a business plan, which gives you something called Linear Insights and Linear Asks. Linear Asks is a deep integration with the likes of Slack, which really works very well for those who communicate using Slack. It has deep GitHub integrations, real-time collaboration with progress tracking, and a really stunning user interface. Recently, I did a video and it dives into how one user is particularly a fanboy of Linear, and he goes deep on how it can be beneficial for the team. So that's a 25-minute video if you want to find it linked below. This application is much better for software development teams that are high performing and want something fast, easy to use, and a little bit off the cuff compared to apps like Jira and Monday.com Dev. So we covered 10 project management tools in that video. Fantastic. We're on to a winner. You can find them all in the description below if you did want to. As per normal, if you want to dive into more tools, jump over to Tool Finder. You'll find loads of them there, and it'll help you to find the best tools and resources. And if you're new here and dying to watch more videos, then do subscribe and like it if you found value in it. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you in a future video, hoping to help you find more productivity tools and softwares for work. Thank you very much, and I'll see you soon. Cheerio.